Handicapper Steve here, handicapping the racing from Newmarket Racecourse here on Wednesday. It is the 14th of April, 2021. We're going to look at almost all the races here on day two of the Craven meeting. But before I get on to that, remember to please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingHit5 for more selections for racecourses around the world. Let's look at almost all the races except races 1, the 115 and the 410, the sixth race. Very tough those races, and we're just not going to look at them. So we'll start off with the second race, the 150, which is the Bet 365 handicap. It's a Class 2 handicap going for a purse $27,500, race for 4-year-olds and upwards. Horses rate 81 to 100. 11 horses are going 1,200 meters or are 6 furlongs on the good to firm rated Rolly Mile Turf course. My top selection, we're going to take the 3 horse going places. We'll go 358 in the Tri-Cash Trifecta. 358 Tri-Cash Trifecta. Top selection 3 horse going places is 5-year-old Gilded by Frankel. Holly Doyle gets the mount for Archie Watson. The horse's most recent outing came the 12th of March at Lingfield, 7 furlongs and a Class 3 handicap, and the horse by 3/4 in length there. Second off the bench, drawn from the inside, had the speed from the rail, and just went all the way, quickened up nicely. It was an all-around easy race for this horse. Two back, the horse ran the 25th of January at Kempton, 7 furlongs and a Class 3 handicap. Second off the bench, he finished third by 2 3/4 lengths, had a little bit of a high weight there, and just really couldn't get going. Maybe around the right hand of Ben, it just wasn't his day to win. And then prior to that, the horse's first start in nearly a year, the 9th of January at Lingfield, 7 furlongs in a Class 5 novice race, this horse put on show, winning by 4 lengths, first start in 11 months, you know, basically, you know, got eased down late, quickened up nicely. That was a very good race off the bench. And prior to that, the horse ran the 17th of February at Kempton, 7 furlongs in a Class 5 novice, where the horse finished second by 2 1/4 lengths, and he really just couldn't get into it there. But he's come back to the turf for the first time since his two-year-old campaign, back to Newmarket. Let's take him here 4-1. Second likeliest winner, I think, is the 5-horse Count Otto. His races over the winter at Lingfield haven't been half bad. Coming here to Newmarket, we'll give him a shot 7-1. But to recount my selection for the second, the 150 from Newmarket, let's take the 3-horse going places. Give kudos to the 5-horse Count Otto, 358, and the Tri-Cash Trifecta. The third race, the 225, it's the European Free Handicap. It's a listed handicap of Class 1 horses going for a purse $48,000, race for 3-year-olds only. We have a field of 7 horses going to post the distance of ground of 1,400 meters or 7 furlongs on the turf course. My top selection and my best bet of the day, I'm going to take the 3-horse Tactical. We'll go 3-2-5 in the Tri-Cash Trifecta. 3-2-5 Tri-Cash Trifecta. Top selection 3-horse Tactical. This 3-year colt by Tornado. Her Majesty the Queen owns this one. Andrew Balding trains. Ocean Murphy gets the mount. They ran the horse against 2 tough competition most recently as a 2-year-old on the 10th of October here at Newmarket. Soft ground, 7 furlongs in the Group 1 Dewhurst. He finished 11 by 13 lengths, and he just wasn't catching St. Mark's Basilica and Wembley. This horse was just never into it. It wasn't his day to win, especially on the wet ground. And then prior to that, he ran okay, I thought, in the Group 1 Middle Park Stakes here at Newmarket, 6 furlongs, 26 September. He finished 4th by 3 1/4 lengths. He just needed that extra turn of foot. Do think the 6 was just a little bit too short, but I didn't think it was a half bad race. And then prior to that, in the Pre-Mornay at Deauville, 6 furlongs in August, he finished 5th by 4 1/2 lengths there. He couldn't keep up with those horses, and also he's just not a 6 furlong horse. He won against, you know, he won against Group 2 quality horses in the July Stakes here in Newmarket over the July course in July. I said the word July way too many times in that last sentence, but he won by 1 1/2 lengths, and he had a great tracking position. He quickened up nicely. He won nicely there. And before that, he was Royal Ascot winner, winning over the 5 furlongs there in Listed Stakes back in June. You know, he can win here today. He's drawn well on the inside. He should get the fast ground back to 7. At 10-1, I like him a lot with Class Relief. Let's take him. Like I said, best bet of the day. To recount my selection for the 225 third race from Newmarket, it's European Free Handicap. Let's take the 3-horse Tactical. We'll go 3-2-5 in the Tri-Cash Trifecta. The co-featured fourth race at 3 o'clock now from Newmarket is the Group 3 Earl of Sefton Stakes. It's Group 3 event for Class 1 horses going for per $61,000, race for 4-year-olds and upwards. 6 horses are going 1,800 meters or 1 1/8 on the Rolly Mile Turf course. We're going to take here the 4-horse Maya Oberon as the top selection. We'll go 4-5-2 in the Tri-Cash Trifecta. 4-5-2 Tri-Cash Trifecta. Top selection 4-horse Maya Oberon. This 4-year-old colt by Dubawi. James Doyle picks up the mount for William Haggis. The horse's most recent outing came the 3rd of October. Red Car, soft ground, 7 furlongs and Listed Stakes. And the horse finished 5th by 7 1/2 lengths there. And he completely hit the wall on the wet ground. He just does not like that. He's getting faster ground today, and I think he's in a more realistic spot to win. Two back in the Group 3 Superior Mile at Haydock, 1 mile September the 5th. He finished 2nd by 1 1/2 lengths, and he stayed the trip well. He needed that extra turn of foot, but I don't think he was going to get it because it was on the soft ground. 2-3 back on very firm ground in the Group 3 Bottoms Thoroughbred Stakes at Goodwood, 1 mile in late July. On the fast ground, he finished 2nd by 2 1/2 lengths. And he was staying in the trip well. He just needed that extra turn of foot. But there he was gaining ground. If the race was a little extra, you know, if it was an extra 16th mile longer, he would have made it interesting. But there was nothing bad about that race. And then prior to that at York, one monoclass, five novice, winning by six. He just won for fun there. That was a very good run. His numbers could definitely win against these horses. 7-2 lets you use him. You can't throw out the five horse San Donato either. Andre Adesini's on this one. Most recent race at Ayr going a mile and a quarter, he just couldn't stay the trip there, but he's come back to the extended mile here today, back to fast ground, back to not the world's toughest horses. You know, he should definitely win against these horses. Looking over some of those races last summer against this very tough Group 2, Group 1 horses, he just was not keeping up with the step-down class, back to a mile and eighth at 7-1. He's another very likely winner using the place pot. But to recount my selection for the 3 o'clock, the 4th race from Newmarket's to Group 3 Earl of Sefton, let's take the 4-horse Maya Oberon, give kudos to the 5-horse St. Donato. We'll go 4-5-2 in the Tricast Trifecta, 4-5 in the place pot. The 5th race now, the 3:35 kind of local prep race for the 1,000 guineas in about 2 weeks' time, 2.5 weeks' time. The 5th race, 3:35, it is the Group 3 Neil Gwynn Stakes. It's Group 3 event for Class 1 horses, going for per $61,500. Race for 3-year-old fillies. 10 horses are going 1,400 meters or 7 furlongs on the turf course. My top selection, we're going to go with the 5 horse here, Sacred. We'll go 5-7-2 in the Tri-Cash Trifecta. 5-7-2 Tri-Cash Trifecta, top selection of 5 horse, Sacred. This 3-year-old filly by Xenia Excel, Ryan Moore's on this one for William Haggis. The horse's most recent outing came 26 September here in Newmarket, 6 furlongs in the Group 1 Chevrolet Park Stakes, and the horse been staved by 12 lengths there, and the horse was just under the drive and just not excelling. It completely hit the wall. It wasn't the day to win. Stepping down to this Group 3, the extra furlong to deal with, I think he's in a more realistic spot to win, and also from a 2-year-old to a 3-year-old campaign, the horse has really improved a lot. Two back at Doncaster, 11th of September, 5 furlongs in the Group 2, Flying Childers Stakes. He finished second by a nose and was all out, quickened up nicely, had a good pace to run into. He just missed late, but there's nothing bad about that race. And then prior to that, in the Group 2, Lowther Stakes at York, 6 furlongs August 20th, he finished second by a length, and he just couldn't get there late, but he still ran a decent race there off the refreshing. And prior to that, in the Queen Mary, 2 months prior at Ascot, 5 furlongs, finished second by 3/4 length. Capanelli just ran a terrific race, went on to win the Prix Mornay later that summer. But this horse, you know, again, was quickening up nicely. He, you know, he has some speed if he wants to use it, but I think the better running style is from coming just off the pace. At 7-1, I should think the horse should get a good tracking position. We'll use her on the ticket. Your second link to this winner here is the 7-horse Seattle Rocket, 20-1, which is nice odds on her. Most races, she's still a main here, but she's been running some very tough races against some very tough horses. Most recently at Goodwood in the Prestige Stakes, where the horse finished third by 7 lengths and just kind of hit the wall late on the soft ground. But prior to that, here over in the Sweet Solaria at Newmarket in August, the horse had a very good third place finish. And then the Duchess of Cambridge, the horse finished 6 by 6.25 lengths. And I just think the 6-furlong trip was just too short that day. But coming to a 7-furlong trip, maybe a little longer in the future to suit her well. But I think at 20-1, she's a horse you want to keep an eye on. So let's use her. So to recount my selection for the 5th, the 3:35 from Newmarket is the Group 3 Neil Gwynn Stakes. Let's take the 5-horse Sacred. Give kudos to the 7-horse Seattle Rock. 5-7-2, Tri-Cash Trifecta. 5-7 in the place pot. We'll skip over race 6 to 4:10 and head on to the nightcap, the 7th race from Newmarket, the 4:45, which is the cash out at Bet365 handicap. It's class 3 handicap, going for per $17,000. Race for 3-year-olds only, horse rate 76-95. 8 horses are going 2,000 meters or a mile and a quarter on the turf course. We'll take the 2 horse just fine as a top selection. We'll go 2-1-5 in the Tri-Cash Trifecta. 2-1-5 Tri-Cash Trifecta, top selection 2 horse just fine. 3-year-old gelding by the Sea of the Stars. Let's give the queen a double here. She owns this one. Sir Michael Stout trains Ryan Moore. Let's give him also a double. Gets the mount. The horse is most recent out came 10th of October at York, soft ground, 1 mile in a class 2 handicap, and the horse finished 3rd by 3/4 length. Just couldn't get there until very late in the run. Also had a little bit of a high weight. Didn't think it was a half bad race, but going to the mile and a quarter today, which I think this horse is really, really set for, he should really get a good trip, and I think he can go all the way. 2 back at Sand on 16th of September, good ground, 1 mile in a class 4 novice, and the horse went by 2.5 lengths there, and was just run a little bit too wide, but got over well, quickened up nicely. If the horse saved a little bit more ground, probably would have won easily, but still a very good race. And then the debut on the 14th of August at Lingfield, 7 furlongs, fast ground, class 5 novice. The horse finished 4th by 4.75 lengths. It was a little lackadaisical early on, just took a little bit of time to get going, but was mowing them down late. I didn't think it was a half bad 4th. With every single race, the horse has been improving. Going to the mile and a quarter today. At 3-1, I think this horse is very live. You can't throw out the one horse act of wisdom either for Godolphin. The horse is a winner of his last three, and as a 2-year-old, he went over the mount a quarter three times, so he's definitely bred for the trip. You know, he should going to fast ground shouldn't be a problem, and, you know, 5-2, we'll definitely use him. Possible Derby horse, we'll have to wait and see. But to recap my selection for the 7th of 4:45 for Newmarket, let's take the 2-horse just fine. Give kudos to the 1-horse Act of Wisdom, 215, Tri-Cash Trifecta, 2-1 in the place pot. So good luck to all, and please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKid5. Good luck, everybody.